Assalamu alaikum. My name is Asim Abdullah Salim.
And my name is Ilyas Swain.
We are the students of Telecom Architecture in the same university in Saudi Arabia. In this video, I will remind you the history, or we will remind you the history of our College of Architecture in the same university.
This college till now has two buildings. This is the old one. Let's go see it.
Hi. Here is the old building of College of Architecture in Qasim University. The College of Architecture, Planning and Design in Qasim University started in 2000 academic year from 2010-2011 with only 31 freshman students. It has full-time dean professor. His name is Sulaiman Yahya, who was promoted as vice dean, rector of planning, development and equality in Qasim University. Dr. Abdul Rahman Al-Farshud became the dean of the dean, and Abdul Aziz Al-Aboudi became the vice dean of on May 2011. Professor Sulaiman and Dr. Al-Aboudi initiated the construction of showroom, which housed the commentary and foundry shops and studio room, which was used for architectural drawings.
After 1 year, we moved to a new building. Let's go see it.
Here is the new building of our college. The first speech of faculties were Dr. Al-Hazmi, who was teaching principle of our architecture design studio. Dr. Jean, who was teaching mathematics and physics. Dr. Jamal Daydami, who teaching the history of our the history of architecture and history of materials. Dr. Thomas Junior, who was teaching structure for architects and environmental control system. Dr. Asad Abu Ghazala, who was teaching studio design, and Architect Fahim, who was teaching digital media in design.
In 2013, an additional 10 architecture will arrive here normally. Dr. Ahmed Osman, Dr. Khalid Hiba, Dr. Mustafa Gharib, and Architect Ihab Sanad, Architect Islam Raikib, Architect Ayman Ghalib, Architect Hisham Al-Fadli, Architect Mudaffar Ali, and Architect Shadi Ukasha, and Architect, last one is Muhammad Al-Zahran. The present Dean of the College, Dr. Muhammad Al-Mawai, and the present setups, city and circle were updated. A condition of architecture program started in 2014. Now, we are going to interview 4 doctors who are very expert in academic, namely Dean Dr. Al-Marwai, Saudi Arabia, Dr. Ahmed Osman from Sudan, Dr. Khalid Hiba from Egypt. The interview will show us the history of their career and their mankind, their work.
Doctor, why did you choose this career?
For so many reasons. Architecture. It is very interesting. Since I was in my primary, is it, or secondary, I was very much fond of drawing, and I have been reading a lot of...
Architecture is a very interesting course that since my primary school, intermediate and high secondary school, I was very much fond of drawing. So therefore, I've chosen this discipline for these reasons, and I found what I was looking for as early as I was young. It seems to be this is exactly why I've chosen this interest in teaching. Then later on in Sudan, I continue to the same line. Since now I got my PhD, and it seems to be very interesting. I was so much interested in the field, meaning to say very much interested in teaching, yeah. Very interesting. I was head of department, I was a deputy dean, I was a dean also, and therefore these posts have made me to somehow help the society in bringing up so many architects and so many academicians as well. Sleepless nights, continuing the whole night drawing and and the first day you have to be as early as 8 in the class, you know, all these are some of the problems that I encountered. But it seems to be such problems would be overcome by time if you love the discipline.
And how did you resolve these problems?
As time goes, you know, in the beginning, actually first year, second year, third year, like now, I don't sleep early. I normally sleep around 2, 3, so it's like it becomes part of my life.
So,
by time, as time goes, somebody will be used to so many things, no matter how difficult they seem to other people.
What are the three qualities that are important, will need us to become more successful in the career?
It seems to be, first of all, somebody has to be interested. Interest.
Yeah.
Secondly, ability. You have to have the abilities of drawing. And the ability of patience.
And the confidence.
And confidence and talent. Again, somebody has to be talented. Mm-hmm. You know, it seems to be these are the three main characteristics that are required for an architect.
What's the standard of English that is requirement in our college?
Not much, actually. You know, architecture depends on drawing. Drawing is a language of its own. But nevertheless, somebody needs to somehow go and read, you know, references, resources, internet. And now, as you know, the modern and the contemporary knowledge requires somebody it requires that somebody should somehow have the ability of at least reading and writing. So it is good to be good in English.
Finally, do you have any advice for the students?
You said?
Do you have any advices for students?
The students, well, generally they should exercise patience. They should also read books, and they should somehow be very cooperative among themselves as colleagues, and they have to respect their instructors. And a lot of things, somebody has to be also ambitious, you know, and somebody should not always think that he should be an architect, but at least somebody could also go into so many other disciplines. But at least the last one that somehow associated with this very interview is like English language. Somebody needs to somehow read more, and somebody has as well needs to be good, actually, you know, English has to be one of the major projections. You know, somebody has to so much be interested in architecture and English as well.
Finally, thank you, Dr.
Academic career or architecture in general? You know, I am an Egyptian.
Yes.
You know, I came from a huge history in architecture. When I was in middle school, I visited the pyramids. Before I decided to be a teacher, looked like my mother. But when I saw the pyramid, you know, I wondered, yes, how they built this great building. From this point, I interested by architecture. But I decided before to be a teacher. For that, I decided to combine between architecture and my hobby to be
teacher.
A teacher. For that, when I joined the university, I decided to be a teacher in university, in my specialist in architecture.
Very good. So also, how did you start your career?
You know, I graduated in 1992 from Alexandria University. But it was difficult to be a staff member there because it is crowded, there is a lot of staff members. For that, I joined as a part-timer to teach there in Alexandria University, and started to prepare my master my master's degree, my master's thesis in Alexandria University. At the same time, I looked for an opportunity in another university. Alhamdulillah, for good, I joined Al Azhar University in 1998 after I got my master's degree. From this time, I'm teaching now in Al Azhar University. But sometimes I go out of Egypt. I went to Bahrain to teach there, and now I am here, and I'm proud of that in Qassim, in Saudi Arabia.
And Doctor, what are the three qualities that are very important that will lead us to become more successful in the career?
You mean architecture?
Yes.
Yes, to be architect. Yeah. Usually, I advise my student to read more and more in all fields. You know, in all fields. The architect should be know more about everything in the world. He should to know everything in political, in history, in economy, in social relation, everything. Because he built for people. For that, he should to read more about everything. That is number one. Number two, he should to improve his skill in sketches and drawings. He should use his eye as a camera, yeah, and he should to translate it into sketches to improve his skills. The architect without skill is poor. This is number one and number two. Number three, or most of architects now or student architect interested by computer. They should know computer in architecture just a tool, not a target. We should to use a computer as a tool, not a target. When you know a lot of programs of computer science in architecture and application in architecture, they should to know that is not a target. But we talk about idea, concept. So he will be a successful.
Why English is very important in our college?
It is very important. You know, because English now is a global language, everybody in all over the world should to learn to teach English, learn English, should to know English, because it's a language for connectivity with another people. A lot of references by English, but we talk about Arabic references, limited number of references, thousand, but in English, millions of reference, it will be available for you. For that, you should to know English. That is the basic language for all fields of knowledge. For that, architect should to know English, should to improve his English,
and do you have any advices for the students who are studying now?
My students, read more and more, try to improve your skills, try to learn English very well. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Dr. Very
much
for the interview. This honor for me.
Thanks.
Thank you. This is our Dean of Architecture in Qassim University in Saudi Arabia. Doctor, why did you choose this career?
I'll be too honest with you. Which is usually directed my to it.
And also, how did you start your career as an academician?
When I'm graduating from the department of the Umm Al Qura University, and I am an academic.
What are the three qualities that are very important that will lead us to become more successful in the career?
I will be clear. The first is patience, and secondly, hard worker, and thirdly, perseverance. Okay.
Doctor, do you have any advice for the students?
Yes, following what God has commanded. That's it.
Finally, thank you for so much.
Thank you indeed.
For interview.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.
Thank you. We take the experience from the doctors, and Dr. Khaled Hebe say, read more and more. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.